Many questions that probability theory tries to address have its motivations and origins in games of chance. I want to exploit this connection to make learning this subject more enjoyable by presenting to you several games. You can initially play these games just for fun, and then as you learn more, try to apply what you have learned to play these games better. Sometimes these games will also motivate the questions that our theory will then address. With this in mind, the games that we will play will be simplified versions of some real-life games. Our first game in this series is a very simplified version of a card game called poker. Later on, we will play more sophisticated variants of this game which are close to poker. In this game, the players get one card each and the player with the higher card wins and gets all the money that was bet. The game starts with both the players putting in one coin, say $1 each, into the common pot. Then they each get a single card from the deck. It is now player A's turn to make a bet. The players look at their own cards and depending on that they make bets, either 0 or 1 or 2. A bet of 0 signifies that the player is surrendering or folding. For example, player A here, whose turn it is to bet, may choose to fold, maybe because his card is very small. In that case, the other player wins and gets all the money in the pot. Let's say player A makes a positive bet, say $1. Now it is player B's turn to make a bet. He can either surrender by betting 0 or match the amount that player A has bet. If player B surrenders, then player A immediately gets all the money in the pot. Otherwise, B must match A's bet, that is, bet the same amount as A. Let's say B matches A's bet by putting in $1. Then they reveal their cards and the player with the higher card gets all the money in the pot. If the two cards are equal, then the players split the money in the pot equally. In our example, let's say player A's card turns out to be a 9 and player B's card turns out to be a 3. So player A wins as 9 is higher than 3 and takes all the money. More generally, cards are compared by their number value, with 2 being the smallest, then 3, 4, 5 and so on. And the face cards are ordered like this, J or Jack being larger than 10, then Q or Queen, then K or King, and then Ace being the highest at 14. I have implemented this game in Excel and now we'll show you how to play it there.
The name of the file is One Card Poker and it's an Excel file. Now if you can open it either using Excel software if you have it on your computer, or maybe using Office 365. Here is what it looks like. Each row of this sheet represents one game. Each game consists of just one round of betting, like I described. In the first game, it is the computer's turn to make the bet to start off with. Then the third column represents the initial amount which the players put into the pot, also called the blind or the NT amount. I fixed it to 1 here. Then the computer looks at its cards and makes the bet 1. I look at my card, it's a 7, it's an okay card. The computer's bet is 1, so maybe it doesn't have a very high card, so I match computer's bet. Now the cards are revealed. The computer had a 4 against my 7, so I win this and I make a total gain of 2 from the 1 initial amount and one additional dollar which the computer had bet. On the top left hand here is the total gains. Now in the second game, it's my turn to bet first. I have a 10, it's a relatively high card, so maybe I'll bet a 2. Turns out the computer also had a 10, it matched my bet and it's a tie. Now it's the computer's turn in the next game. He has bet 1, so maybe I have a 6. It's a reasonable card. Maybe I'll also match the computer's bet. And it turns out to be a tie again. Now in the fourth game, it's my turn to bet first. 9 is somewhat high. Maybe I'll bet a 1. The computer matched my bet and the cards are revealed. The computer had a king, so it wins. And I lose $2, one because of the initial amount and one because of the additional bet that I had made here, and so on. Let me show you one more. In the next game, I have an ace. The computer bets 1, so I match its base bet because ace is the highest, and I win this round, and so on. Now the nice thing about it is that if you know a little bit of Excel, you can also write a little piece of code which encodes your strategy, and that way you can test whether how effective your strategy is over the long run.